There is another detective that you should be aware of. His name's Tapp. He's smart and he's getting closer.
I know who he is. I need you to lead him to someone for me. A doctor. A healer who needs some healing.
This is yours, Doctor.
Hey, YouTubers, and welcome back to another Saw Jigsaw discussion video. Today, we're going to be talking really more so about a theory that I've had for the last couple of weeks now about how Hoffman might have all along been trying to push Detective Tapp into the right direction, where he was actually helping Detective Tapp bring down John in a glorious way that would get him out of his blackmail situation and make it so he didn't have to be an apprentice or even help John throughout the entire series from what we saw in the first film. Now, whether or not that makes any sense to you guys right now, I implore you to keep listening to me and hear all my thoughts and opinions on this as they're played out. And to start all this out, what we saw at the very beginning of this video is a clip from Saw 5 as we saw Peter Strom try to go through all of the past Saw traps and figure out exactly how Hoffman was connected to those and maybe how he was helping John throughout the entirety of the franchise. It was a really great way for Saw 5 to really try to catch Hoffman's character up and make it clear that he was helping from almost the very beginning of the Saw trap mythology and trying to figure out a way to weave in the grander story. This flashback is trying to show us that both John and Hoffman are both well aware of Detective Tapp and his proximity to the entire Jigsaw case. The fun thing about this scene is it's supposed to be a direct reference from the shooting script, at least as far as I'm aware, because Detective Tapp or Danny Glover was supposed to reprise his role but couldn't due to a scheduling conflict. So as they went into the flashback as Detective Fisk told Detective Hoffman that they had found another body and it ended up being Seth Baxter, the trap that Hoffman put on in Saw 5, it was actually Detective Tapp telling him that he was going to be put on the case and he was the one on the case for a very long time. This kind of muddies the water because that didn't actually end up happening, but they tried to keep that scene in the context of the film just to elaborate on Detective Tapp's role in the Saw franchise and how important he was to the very first film. I applaud them for that, but it would have been better if Danny Glover was actually in the fifth Saw film. So yeah, I understand that both of them are aware, but he didn't really have a huge role, and it's kind of weird to name drop him when we haven't seen him for at least four other films. I mean, this guy kind of came and disappeared. He wasn't as close to the franchise as Carrie or Rigg or Eric Matthews or even at that point Fisk. I mean, all these other people were way better at their roles than Detective Tapp was at that point in the franchise. But the question remains, what does this mean to the overall scope of the story? And even setting up the idea of whether or not Hoffman, from the events of Saw 1, was actually trying to set Detective Tapp up to catch John and arrest him or maybe even kill him in a way to allow Hoffman to get out of the blackmail situation that he found himself in from the very beginning. And in order to explain this, I just have to explore one more clip from the movie, so we'll be right back.
Remember 118th Street?
K2K. That gang's territory was only about four blocks.
Now listen to this. We gotta check the records for all the fire emergencies that occurred in that area within the last 2 weeks. Go right now!
So if you ask me, you cannot understate the importance of this scene to the overall franchise. This is the only time in the entire series where we find John being put off guard by someone coming into his workshop. At the very beginning of Saw 2, they raid the steel company and John barely even flinches. Throughout Saw 3, 4, and 5, he has a tape specifically dedicated to Peter Strom because he knows Peter will actually make his way into the Gideon meatpacking plant. This guy plans for everything, and it's not like John didn't plan for these people to actually come, and he had a way out of the situation. But once Detective Tapp and Detective Singh actually make their way into his workshop, we see him limping out. He's not walking out. He's not strolling out. This guy was taken off guard by their presence, and he was just simply smart enough to plan for all contingency purposes. But how did this happen? How did he make this huge mistake where the fire alarm and the K2K symbol actually alerted them to where his workshop was if it wasn't for Hoffman setting him up in the first place? Now, I know a lot of people might say, well, if you actually listen to the commentary track for Saw 5, or at least go from some of the things the writers have said and everyone have said throughout the last couple years and even some of the fan base, then you have to look at the fire that happened in Saw 1 was actually the fire that they talked about throughout most of Saw 5. And yes, I still think that that makes a ton of sense, and I don't really want to take anything away from that. But I'm just looking at it from this theory perspective. It would be awesome to know that Hoffman undermined John at this particular point, set off that fire alarm in one of the nearby buildings, or maybe even that building, in order to make Detective Tapp and Detective Singh figure it out. Because he knew just how much Detective Tapp was invested into this case and how addicted he was to watching this footage over and over and over again. And this was just a subtle way of Hoffman trying to get the upper hand on John at least once. And we already know that Hoffman has a tendency to blackmail people and set people up in a pretty obvious way, to the point where he wanted to be the only one in charge of the games, and he also tried to make a run for it after everything happened in Saw 7, but not because he was trying to give up the legacy. He only picked it back up again after fulfilling all of John's will from Saw 6, just to get back at Jill for what she did to him at the end of that movie. This is my opinion here, just a theory. I think Hoffman, at least at this moment, was trying to set up John, trying to get out of the blackmail situation. The best way he knew possible was to subtly help the police try to find him and maybe even take him out. But I want to hear y'all's thoughts and opinions on this in the comment section below. Do you think that this holds merit, or do you think I'm stretching? I mean, any other perspective is greatly appreciated. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Hit that bell over by the subscriber button for more notifications every single time I upload, especially my Jigsaw content, because I know a lot of you guys really appreciate that stuff, and I'm always willing to do more of this stuff. Just to talk about it in general. Not a lot of people talk about this franchise anymore, and I think it's a great shame, because this is one of the best horror franchises that I've ever seen. Definitely my favorite. If it's y'all's favorite, tell me in the comment section below. I hope everyone's having a fantastic day. Share this video out to all your friends so they can share their thoughts and opinions on this as well. It's been real, guys.